Welcome to the Edwards. Today we are going to discuss the Hindu newspaper of 24 January 2023. This is the study IQ IAS prelims batch. It is starting from tomorrow 5 January from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. Now today's headline of the Hindu. Harassment allegation by athlete absurd, Lal. Amid a growing clamour for the resignation of the Haryana minister Sandeep Singh, who gave up sports and youth affairs portfolio over allegations of sexual harassment, Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar on Tuesday said the woman athlete had made absurd allegations. Mr. Manohar Lal Khattar said the minister, who is in the form of captain of Indian hockey team, had already relinquished the portfolio for an impartial probe into the matter. So it is just a, you can say, harassment allegation put by the woman on the sports minister. Okay, now no need for extra curbs on free speech of ministers, Supreme Court. A statement by a minister cannot be attributed vicariously to government by invoking principle collective responsibility. PM and CM does not have disciplinary control over all members, says bench. Now here, Justice V. Ram Subramaniam. The state is under a duty of affirmatively protect the rights of a person under the Article 21. Whenever there is a threat to personal liberty, even by a non-state actor, state has an obligation to intervene when acts of a private actor may threaten the life of liberty of another individual. Now, we do not believe in war, but will fight if forced to, Rajnath. The CM bridge inaugurated by the defense minister in Arunachal Pradesh on Tuesday. So here, due to the, you can say, due to the tension which is being held in the Arunachal Pradesh, which is okay. So due to this, the Indian defense is being increasing in the Arunachal Pradesh. Here you can see the Simon Bridge, which is being inaugurated by the defense minister in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, defense minister Rajnath Singh. Okay, now hate and run case, we will discuss that earlier. Rahul Gandhi Bharat Jodo Yatra enters UP. Okay, now here UP mein enter ho chuki Rahul Gandhi ki. Congress General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi Vadra on Tuesday welcomed her brother Rahul Gandhi, who led his Bharat Jodo Yatra from Delhi into Uttar Pradesh. I am proud of my brother, she said. Okay, now here you can see changing address on Aadhaar now made easier. Okay, so एक तो ये अथॉरिटी आप लोग जानते ही हैं, यूनिक आइडेंटिफिकेशन अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया, ओके, UIDAI. दिस अथॉरिटी डील्स विद द आधार कार्ड एंड आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ अ सिटीजन, ओके, ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ अनाउंस्ड ऑन ट्यूसडे दैट रेसिडेंट्स वुड वंस अगेन बी एबल टू चेंज देयर एड्रेस ऑन आधार कार्ड बाय हैविंग द हेड ऑफ फैमिली इंडोर्स देयर रिक्वेस्ट. Any one above the age of 18 can act as a head of the family, okay, and can update the address on the card for a relative he she lives with by providing a proof of their relationship, such as marriage certificate, passport, birth certificate, कास्ट और राशन कार्ड। द हेड ऑफ फैमिली रिसीव्स एन SMS आफ्टर द एप्लीकेंट पेज। ओके सो इट इज़ नॉट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बट वी हैव टू यू कैन से रिकॉल दैट यूनिक आइडेंटिफिकेशन अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया डील्स विद आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया। ओके इट इज़ रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द आधार कार्ड। ओके आधार कार्ड इज़ अ प्राइमरी डॉक्यूमेंट विच अ सिटीजन हैव मस्ट हैव टू सेव फॉर themselves। ओके इट प्रूव्स आइडेंटिटी दैट यू आर इंडियन। ओके नाउ बिगिन योर जर्नी। ओके तो हेयर वी कैन सी द श्रुति शर्मा विच इज़ बींग द टॉपर ऑफ 2021 CSE एग्जाम्स सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जाम्स। ओके नाउ साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटी मस्ट वर्क टू फुलफिल कंट्रीज नीड। ओके नाउ दिस इज रिलेटेड टू साइंस एंड टेक पार्ट। ओके नाउ इंडिया साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटी शुड वर्क टू मेक कंट्रीज कंट्री आत्मनिर्भर सेल्फ रिलायंट। प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी सेड ऑन ट्यूजडे ही सेड फुलफिलिंग इंडियाज रिक्वायरमेंट्स शुड बी एट द रूफ टॉप ऑफ ऑल इंस्पिरेशन फॉर साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटी। एड्रेसिंग 108th इंडियन साइंस कांग्रेस एट नागपुर महाराष्ट्र। तो इन इंडियन साइंस कांग्रेस इंडियन साइंस कांग्रेस ओके 108th इन महाराष्ट्र थ्रू वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस मिस्टर मोदी एक्सप्रेस्ड हैप्पीनेस अबाउट द थीम ऑफ द इवेंट दिस ईयर विच कम्बाइन सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट विद वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट। ओके सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट वी ऑल नो दैट विदाउट हार्मिंग द नेचर। ओके विदाउट हार्मिंग द नेचर। ओके वी हैव टू डेवलप एज we have to do development without harming the nature so that the future generations can't sacrifice the resources. Okay they have much availability of resources in this way we have to develop ourselves. Okay we have to make development. Okay now our thinking is not merely to empower women through science but also empower science by contribution of women he said. Okay हमें सिर्फ साइंस की मदद लेके वुमेन को एम्पावर नहीं करना है बल्कि वो साइंस को एम्पावर करना है ठीक है बाय द कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ वुमेन। ओके नाउ हाइलाइटिंग द अचीवमेंट्स ऑफ वुमेन शोकेस्ड देयर स्ट्रेंथ टू द वर्ल्ड। मिस्टर मोदी गेव द एग्जांपल ऑफ मुद्रा योजना विच हैज़ बीन इंस्ट्रूमेंटल एंड इन एम्पावरिंग वुमेन इन इंडिया। The increasing participation of women in proof that women and science are both progressing in nation, he said. Now, here is the advertisement, guys. Okay. Let us discuss about the bridge, Siom Bridge. Okay. Siom Bridge is being inaugurated in the Arunachal Pradesh, okay, by the Defense Minister on Tuesday. 2nd January. Now, India has always been against war, but if it is imposed upon us, we will fight. Defense Minister Rajnath Singh in Arunachal Pradesh on Tuesday, as he inaugurated 28 infrastructure projects built by the BRO, okay, Border Road Organization. Now, the project built at a cost of 724 crore include 22 bridges. तो ये जो project है जिसमें कि उन्होंने 28 infrastructure build करने कहा है to make the defense more powerful and competitive to China. उसके लिए जो total धनराशि ली गई है हमारी वो ली गई है 724 crores. Okay. Include 22 bridges. एंड थ्री रोड्स स्प्रेड अक्रॉस सेवरल स्टेट्स। ओके मतलब 22 ब्रिजेज हैं तीन रोड है और उसके बाद हमारा 28 इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है टू डेवलप द अरुणाचल प्रदेश एरिया विच इज़ बींग इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द चाइना टू गेट मोर डिफेंसिव अगेंस्ट द चाइना। ओके नाउ द वर्ल्ड इज विटनेसिंग अ नंबर ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स टूडे। ओके India has always been against war. It is our policy. We do not believe in war. But if it falls upon to now, our armed forces are ready, and it is heartening to see that BRO is walking shoulder to shoulder with them. He said at the ceremony on the Siom Bridge. Okay. हमारा यू कैन से एक इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बन के रेडी हो गया सीएम ब्रिज। नाउ टू डेज आफ्टर 20-year-old woman dragged to death in outer Delhi Sultanpuri area, victim friend tells police she left the spot fearing consequences. Police dismissed the family claims that victim had gone to attend a work event. Police dismissed the family claim that victim had gone to attend a work event for New Year. Friends and family dragging during funeral procession on the Tuesday. Okay. So here, just note down that section 24. Okay. स्पेशल सी पी लॉ एंड ऑर्डर जोन ओके सागर प्रीत हुड्डा सेट द स्टेटमेंट हैज़ बीन रिकॉर्डेड अंडर द सेक्शन 124 ऑफ पुलिस एक्ट ओके सी आर पी सी कोड ऑफ क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर ओके नाउ मूव फॉरवर्ड ओके नाउ स्टॉप शेमिंग विक्टिम सेज डब्ल्यू फैमिली बिड्स टीयरफुल फेयरवेल स्टेडफास्ट ऑन डिमांड फॉर जस्टिस एमिड हैवी सिक्योरिटी डिप्लॉयमेंट हंड्रेड्स ऑफ ओके पुलिस फंडर कीप एन आउटसाइड द क्रीमेशन विद वाइल्ड एवेयर इंजरीज सिंग लास्ट राइट्स वर परफॉर्म्ड ऑन ट्यूजडे ओके इट इज बींग टेकिंग एन ह्यूज डिमांड ओके making a huge you can say becoming big issue okay so government must respond to it and it is very shameful for that family which has lost their one daughter okay which is being the only source of earning in her family now aap wants dismissal of DCP BJP slams personal attack now chief minister Arvind Kejriwal on Tuesday spoke to the victim's mother and announced a compensation of 10 lakh for the family. A group of Aam Aadmi Party MLA on Tuesday met Delhi Police Commissioner Sanjay Arora and sought the dismissal of DCP Outer Harendar K. Singh for allegedly shielding the accused in the Sultanpuri hit and run case, rating that one of the accused, Manoj Mittal, is a local BJP worker. ओके आप ऑल्सो डिमांडेड द सैकिंग ऑफ पुलिसमैन डिप्लॉयड ऑन द रूट अलॉन्ग विच द विक्टिम हैज वॉज ड्रैग्ड द लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर हैज़ टाइम टू डिस्टर्ब द वर्क ऑफ द दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट बट डज नॉट हैव टाइम टू प्रोवाइड सिक्योरिटी टू दिल्ली वूमेन ओके आप लीडर आतिश ओके इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट नाउ रिस्पॉन्डिंग टू इट दिल्ली बीजेपी वर्किंग प्रेसिडेंट वीरेंद्र सचवेदा शेड नॉट Only the LG but the Union Home Ministry too has to taken the incident very seriously and up was marking political motivated statement. It is a matter of regret that Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal himself has spoken irresponsibly on this matter and he has given freedom to his party colleagues to speak freely on such a sensitive matter which is undesirable he added. Mr. Sachdeveda said AAP's personal attack on the DCP was politically motivated because the officer has 3 years ago inquired into the incident of LGD assault on then Chief Minister Secretary by AAP MLA. Since then the DCP has been on target of AAP Aadmi Party, he said. Meanwhile, Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal on Tuesday spoke to the victims of 10 lakh. AAP Chief स्पोक पर्सन सौरभ इट्स नॉट इम्पोर्टेंट यार इट्स बीन अ केस इट डजेंट कम इन द UPSC बट वी हैव टू थिंक वी हैव टू get ready, we have to open our antennas, okay? This is not important for prelims section, from prelims point of view, but it can be important from the mains point of view, okay? Such as, agar, just think about it. A girl who is 20 year old, okay, had been got into an accident and being dragged, okay? Now the policeman at the night patrolling, okay, night police patrolling, doesn't see the victim, okay? It's being a political issue, okay? Is woman unsafe? Is there no one who can get a justice, who can fight for the justice, okay? Why police is being, you can say, defending the victims? So think like that, okay? You have to get ready always your antennas for the prelims. You have to read everything, okay? Learn everything. You have to read everything, every and everything, but you have to learn only that things which are relevant for prelims and which you see can asked on, you can relate to it in the mains, okay? If there is any quote, you can write it down, you can make a note, okay? You can think about that, how to use this quote in intro, in the body, or in the conclusion of your answers, okay? So this is important, yaar. Not only reading newspaper is important, okay? Read everything, learn only those, make notes of only those which you think are relevant, which you think you can use in your answers during the mains, okay? Which you think that this fact can be came in the UPSC prelims, okay? So maintain those things, okay? You have to read everything, but learn only those which are relevant for prelims and mains, okay? And make your study material not very bulky, okay? Now Vaisi takes a swipe at BJP's India heaven for minorities, okay? Not for that, not very important, yaar. Please avoid the political issues, okay? Just read everything, okay? But political issues are those issues which can't give you any, you can say, perspective, any path to think about that it can be an accident mains or prelims, okay? You can focus on the science attack, IR, governance part, okay? Current affairs, only this can cover your UPSC prelims, okay? For polity, you refer to Lakshmikant. For history, you refer to old NCRTs and Bipin Chandra, okay? Spectrum, that's it. So this is important. Call for permanent cancellation of bauxite mining lease in Odisha. Now this section is important, yaar, okay? Because here the bauxite mining is going on, okay? And it is being cancelled. So you have to note the where is being the bauxite locations, okay? Where the bauxite ores is, bauxite minings are being located in India, okay? From the geography point of view, okay? Those who have the geography optionals, they must have to do it, okay? Has taken or decided to take the geography optionals. For them it is important. Now villagers reach Bhuvaneshwar, okay? Days ahead, in a public hearing, raise voices against granting environmental clearance to Mali Parvat bauxite mining, okay? Mali Parvat bauxite mining is located in Bhuvaneshwar, okay? Now 3 days before, Odisha State Pollution Control Board, okay, is scheduled to hold a fresh public hearing regarding the environment clearance, you see, to Mali Parvat bauxite mining lease in Koraput, okay? Koraput district. Villagers have reached Bhuvaneshwar demanding permanent cancellation to the lease. अब ये जो bauxite mining है, ठीक है, माली पर्वत बॉक्साइट माइन है जो ये लोकेटेड है कोलापुत डिस्ट्रिक्ट में, और वो डिस्ट्रिक्ट जो है लोकेटेड उड़ीसा में। तो अल्टीमेटली यू कैन से दैट माली पर्वत बॉक्साइट माइनिंग इज बीइंग लोकेटेड इन उड़ीसा इन कोरापुत डिस्ट्रिक्ट। ओके, सो जस्ट सी ऑन द मैप, लोकेट ऑन द मैप, ओके, दैट्स बीइंग द जॉब यार। नाउ शाह टेक्स कांग्रेस टू प्रोजेक्ट जेडीज एज अ बी टीम ऑफ द बीजेपी, नोट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। नाउ इनॉग्रेशन 18th नेशनल स्काउट गाइड जैम बोर। ओके, अब हेयर 18th नेशनल स्काउट गाइड जैम बोर, ओके, फ्रॉम 4th to 10th January 2023 बाय द श्रीमती द्रौपदी मुर्मू। अब हेयर वी हैव टू सर्च द नेशनल स्काउट गाइड प्रोग्राम। ओके, वॉट इज बींग अंडर द नेशनल स्काउट गाइड प्रोग्राम। ओके, नाउ दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, ऑन अ ह्यूज कैंपस ऑफ 222 acres। दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट। नाउ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग ऑफ द हिंदू, द एडिटोरियल। ओके, नाउ द हेडिंग ऑफ द एडिटोरियल इज प्रिवेंटिंग एनिमल क्रुएल्टी इज अ ड्यूटी ऑफ द स्टेट। नाउ ओवर डिफरेंशियल वाइल अपहोल्डिंग डीमोनेटाइजेशन सुप्रीम कोर्ट फेल्ड टू होल्ड गवर्नमेंट अकाउंटेबल। नाउ स्लो एंड स्टेडी प्रेसिडेंट लूला मस्ट नेगोशिएट ब्राजील्स कंजर्वेटिव पॉलिसी। इट इज क्रूशियल फॉर इंडिया टू इम्ब्रेस मल्टी डोमेन ऑपरेशंस। नाउ ओपिनियन अ लेट बट राइट कॉल फॉर बाय केरला गवर्नर। बीजेपी बिड टू मेक इट मार्क इन पंजाब, द लिंक बिटवीन डायबिटीज वेल्थ एंड अवेयरनेस। नाउ फर्स्ट एडिटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, सो कीप योर एंटीनाज ऑन, ठीक है, प्लीज फोकस ऑन इट। नाउ हेयर द एडिटर इज सुरित पार्थसारथी इज एन एडवोकेट प्रैक्टिसिंग इन द मद्रास हाई कोर्ट। ओके, नाउ सून अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बेंच ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया विल डिलीवर इट्स वर्डिक्ट ऑन द वैलिडिटी ऑफ तमिलनाडुज लॉ परमिटिंग द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ जलीकट्टू इन द स्टेट। ओके, तो जलीकट्टू इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स, यू कैन नॉट वेरी स्पोर्ट्स, इज द फॉर्म ऑफ एन आर्ट। ओके, इन लाइक मार्शल आर्ट्स। ओके, नाउ यूजुअली हेल्ड ड्यूरिंग द पोंगल सीजन। अब हेयर इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर यू कैन से इन्वायरमेंट। ओके, पोंगल सीजन वॉट इज बींग What the season is when the Pongal festival is being celebrated in the... Okay, now here Jallikattu is a sport where men compete against each other to hold on the humps of the agitated bulls that... Okay. Not like martial arts, okay. It is being a festival in which the men compete or you can say race with the help with being over hump, with being hold to humps of the bulls, okay. मतलब अल्टीमेटली यू कैन से भैंस और बर्धे की सवारी करते हैं लोग, ठीक है। नाउ बुल्स दैट आर रिलीज्ड इनटू एन ओपन एरिया इन 2014 एनिमल वेलफेयर बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया, ओके, नागराज टू जज बेंच ऑफ द सुप्रीम कोर्ट डिक्लेयर जल्लीकट्टू इल एजिटिमेट। द कोर्ट फाउंड दैट द प्रैक्टिस वॉज क्रूल and cause the animal unnecessary pain and suffering. Since the Tamil Nadu has made efforts to resurrect the sport's legality, it is the fact of revival which is now at stake. Animal rights and safety. So here, the rights of animal and safety are being discussed. Okay, so it is important, this whole, you can say is important for the एनवायरमेंट सेक्शन यार, ठीक है, एनिमल का प्रिजर्वेंस। ओके, फॉर दैट नाउ ओरल आर्ग्यूमेंट्स मेड इन द केस शोड अस जस्ट हाउ कॉम्प्लिकेटेड सम ऑफ द इशूज इन्वॉल्व इन द डिस्प्यूट एरिया डिस्प्यूट आर। इन सम वेज द हियरिंग्स ऑल्सो अंडरलाइन द डिफिशियंसीज इनहेरेंट इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वेन इट कम्स टू एड्रेसिंग क्वेश्चन ऑन एनिमल वेलफेयर। ओके, देयर फोर how the court chooses to resolve the questions posed to it could come to have a deep bearing on the future of animal rights, okay, and safety in our country. None of the guarantees contained in the part third of the Constitution, which deals with the fundamental rights and explicitly conferred to animals. Article 14, right to equality, and Article 21, right to life and personal liberty, are bestowed on persons. Until now, we have generally understood persons to mean human beings, or in some cases, associations of human beings, such as corporations, partnerships, trust, the like, no doubt. Some of the DPSP directive principles of the state policy and fundamental duties contained respectively in Part 4 and Part 4A of the Constitution reflect the responsibility placed on the state and on human beings to protect. Okay. Here you can see a man which is being getting on the hump, okay, of a bull. So here just see the face of that bull. He is being in a happy mood. He is getting intense pain by the man, okay, for doing such an activity, such a bad activity to him, okay. So this is being focused by the some good peoples of the Tamil Nadu, and okay, some good peoples of the Tamil Nadu and being inaugurated. Now, improve the natural environment, but these are unenforceable obligations. Therefore, when efforts to legislate on animal welfare were first made, they did not emanate as much out of a belief that animals were vested with rights as they did from a more elementary ethical precept that our collective conscience ought to make it clear that it was normally wrong to inflict unnecessary pain and suffering on animals. It was with the vision in the mind that Parliament enacted the Prevention of Cruelty Animals Act, PCA Act 1960. To just note it down, the PCA Act, Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act, okay. Prevention to Cruelty to Animals Act, okay, in 1960 has been in the Parliament, okay. Now try to read. It was with the visions in the mind that the Parliament enacted, jo Parliament thi 1960 mein enacted the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act, okay. Now the PCA Act isn't without its shortcomings. While it criminalizes several types of actions that causes cruelty to animals, it exempts, for example, from its coverage the use of animals for experiment with a viewing of securing medical advancement. You know that for medical classes, the frog is being taken to use as a, you can say, surgery object, okay? But being now, it is being, you can say, demolished, okay? Now, but what is clear, as the Supreme Court previously affirmed in A. Nagaraja, is that Jallikattu falls within the boundaries of the actions forbidden by the PCA Act. It is for this reason that the present effort of regulating the practice seeks to create a blanket exemption. When Tamil Nadu amended the PCA Act in 2017, it did not on the basis of the both state and the union government have the power to legislate on issues concerning cruelty to animals. Now, it specifically excluded Jallikattu from the confines, okay, of the statute's various protections. It also secured the precedent's imprimatur for the law and thus attempted to save the legislation from the accusation that it was repugnant to the PCA. Protection to Cruelty of Animals Act, okay, therefore illegal. Now, arguments of petitioners. Judicial review of legislation can broadly be made on two grounds. One, on whether the legislature possesses the competence to enact the law, and two, on whether the law violates one or the other. Okay, now, one or the other of the fundamental rights delineated part 3rd of the Constitution. Tamil Nadu's amendments, the petition claim failed on both grounds. First, the petitioners recognized that both the union and the state legislature have equal power to make the law on the prevention of animal cruelty relatable as it is to entry 17 of the concurrent list of schedule 7 to the Constitution. तो जो ये प्रिवेंशन ऑफ एनिमल क्रुएल्टी एक्ट है, ठीक है, प्रिवेंशन ऑफ क्रुएल्टी टू एनिमल्स एक्ट जो है, ये तो ये किस में आता है, एज इट इज टू एंट्री 17 ऑफ द कॉन्करेंट लिस्ट में आता है, ठीक है, मतलब बोथ स्टेट एंड यूनियन डील विद दैट मैटर, ओके, of schedule 7 of the constitution, but the law regulating jallikattu according to them by the excluding of the practice from the PCA act has the effect of condoning cruelty on animals and hence must be seen as colorable action that bears no nexus to entry 17. Second, the petitioner submitted that the supreme court arrived at clear findings of the fact and law in 2014. In A. Nagaraja, the court had held the Jallikattu in and by itself amounted to a violation of existing provisions of the PCA Act and the fundamental duties contained in the Article 51A. Okay. Now, which requires citizens to protect and improve the natural environment including forests, lakes, rivers. Okay. So, let us read about once more time, okay, in by itself amounted to a violation of the existing provisions of the PCA Act and the fundamental duty contained in the 51A. जो हमारी fundamental duty है वो किस article में आती है, article 51A में, ठीक है, which requires citizen, इसमें हमारी duty बनती है, एक citizen की duty बनती है, एक नागरिक की duty बनती है कि वो protect करे and improve the natural environment including forest, lake, rivers, okay, मतलब उसको improve करे, उसकी fundamental duty बनती है, ठीक है, and wildlife and to have compassion for living creatures. The effect of this violation, the court had held a direct bearing on the right to life contained in the Article 21. The bench was conscious that the right in Article 21 is conferred only on human beings, but the expanded meaning of the word life over the years, which now included a right against disturbance to the basic. अगर आप अभी तक के लोग समझते थे कि जो वो right to life है, ठीक है, right to live, आर्टिकल 21A जो कि राइट टू लिव है, ठीक है, उसको लोग समझ रहे थे कि वो सिर्फ ह्यूमन बींग्स के लिए, बट ड्यू टू द एक्सपेंशन ऑफ द वर्ड लाइफ, ओके, ड्यू टू द एरिया बींग कवर्ड बाय द वर्ड लाइफ, इट इज़ बींग इम्पॉर्टेंट, ठीक है, नाउ इट इज़ नॉट ओनली सर्टेन टू द ह्यूमन बींग, ओके, इट्स बींग टू द ऑल लाइफ विच आर बेसिक टू मैच्योर्ड और म्यूटेंट, ओके, it is their rights to live, okay, now basic environment ought to mean that animal life must be also treated with intrinsic worth, honor and dignity, the court found. Now both sets of argument made by the petitioners called for a deep reflection, but the latter argument on infraction of fundamental rights raises several allied questions. Do animals have personhood? Does our idea of justice include a guarantee of animal rights? If not, do we still owe a duty of care towards our fellow creatures? What does that duty entail? How does it balance with other rights guaranteed by the human beings? Now, care towards animal. On a reasonable reading the Constitution, it might be difficult to hold that animals are promised rights to live life and personal liberty under the Article 21 and equality under the Article 14. Right to equality under Article 14. Right to live, right to life under Article 21. A conclusion to that effect could be well lead to bizarre consequences. Arguments in the favor of personhood invariably spring out of a belief that animals, especially certain kinds of animals such as apes, elephants and whales, share much in common with human beings. But as the philosophers Martha Nussbaum says, our duty of care towards animals need to hardly originate out of our similarities to them. We must instead see each form of animal life is all its beauty and strangeness. Now therefore, rather than focusing on personhood, the better approach to the dispute, the approach that maintains a greater fidelity to our constitution's text and values is to see it in the context of our own right to live in the world that treats animals with equal concern. The judgment in A. Nagaraja hinted at this approach but stopped short of fleshing it out. Article 21 Justice K.S. Radhakrishna held, no doubt, safeguards only the rights of human being, but the word life is today understood to mean something more than mere existence. It means an existence that allows us, among other things, to live in a clean and healthy environment. Indeed, it is possible to argue that a human right to a healthy environment would include a human right to animal welfare. Viewed thus, our governments would be constitutionally obligated to take measures to help the flourishing of our fellow creatures. In these conceptions, legislating to prevent animal cruelty is no longer an option. It transforms into binding duty cast of the state. Okay, so this is the editorial. What a fantastic editorial, yaar. I loved this two reading. From reading this editorial, you are clear about the polity, you are clear about the articles, you are clear about the acts, you are clear about the environment, you are clear about your fundamental duty, you are clear about your rights. Okay, so this all the facts. That's why every topper suggest to read the newspaper. Okay, it gives you immense knowledge. Okay, at a particular time of reading, within the 1 or 1.5 hour, you cover each topic of the UPSC syllabus. You cover the history, you cover the polity, you cover the economics, you cover the, you can say, current affairs, you cover the environment, you cover the art and culture, you cover everything, guys. So it is the need to read the newspaper, okay, daily from 1 to 1.5 hours if you are making notes. Okay, if you are not making notes, then within 45 to 1 hour you can get through it. Okay, so this is all. Preventing animal cruelty is a duty. Okay, just a quick revision. Okay, Animal Welfare Board. Okay, a case is being filed by A. Nagaraja. Okay, now it's being on the spot, being celebrated or being operated in the Tamil Nadu region. Okay, now animals' rights and safety. Okay, as you know, Article 14 deals with the right to equality, Article 21 deals with the right to live, okay, right to life and personal liberty, okay, for persons. But this is not only sustained to the person. Here the word life is not being the life of a human being, okay? It's being beyond that. It's being the life which is being existed on earth has enough right to live freely, okay? Live in the healthy and a beautiful environment, okay? It's being there a right. So this is a decision which is being made, this is the judgment which is being given by the Supreme Court to the states, okay, to the Tamil Nadu, okay. Now, fundamental duties, under our fundamental duties, okay, there is being, it is our duty to take care of the environment, okay. Under Article 51A, here the fundamental duties came, and in which there is a point, you know, there is a duty to protect. It is our duty, it is a duty of the citizens of the country, India, to protect and improve the natural environment, including forests, lakes, reserves, rivers, and wildlife, okay. And to have a compassion for living creatures. Unki compassion bhi ho, ek sambhavna, matlab ek humbleness ho, ek honor ho, theek hai? Towards the living creatures, okay, towards the animals, okay. So this is, and also note down that an act what is being passed by the parliament in 1960, which is enacted as the Prevention of Cruelty to the Animals Act, okay. So just please read in this manner, okay, just retain, revise it. If you think anything important, just make the notes. Now we are going to discuss the second editorial, which is being titled as, "It is crucial for India to embrace multi-domain operations." Now, okay, here the editor is Air Vice Marshal Manmohan Bahadur, VM, retired, is former Additional Director General of Center of Air Power Studies, New Delhi. Now, the India-China skirmish. Now here, this word skirmish you can use in your main setting, okay? So just use like that, okay? If you increase your English, it will help you in fetching out the good marks, okay? You can be stood away from all the being the competitor, and you have to get a limelight, okay? So that's all. It will also help you in the your CSAT, and it also helps you to increase your knowledge. Yeah, the main thing is your knowledge is being extended, okay? If anyone who is being preparing for UPSC, this person is being very different for preparing UPSC, for preparing for any other exam, his knowledge is being increasing day by day, if he is being working hard, okay? There is a relation between success in an exam and knowledge, okay? If your knowledge is being increasing, then it must be a success in your exam, okay? At a particular point, okay, your knowledge must reach, okay? Not a particular point, it is not always constant, okay? Day by day, if someone who is being working too much hard, then his knowledge is being increasing, okay? So now, let us come to the point here. India-China skirmish on the Arunachal Pradesh border has brought the Chinese threat on the front burner again, okay? This has made External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar accept that to counter this threat, we have a deployment of the Indian Army that we have never had. The threat had never decreased but faded in public consciousness due to electioneering, bridge collapse, yatras, G20, etc. Low level and geographical restricted clashes will keep recurring, but what is this should not do is to lull us into a complacent mindset that accepts such clashes where the Indian jawans gives back more with sticks and fisticuffs than what he receives. As likely future conflict scenario with China, the threat actually is at the other extreme, technical advancement in the concept of multi-domain operations, MDO. Okay, now understanding multi-domain operations, we are going to understand in this para that what is being under the multi-domain operations, in which domain the operations are being held, okay, in which multiple domains the operation are being held. The term MDO, multi-domain operations, has entered Indian's military lecture circuit big time. However, it is being banded about loosely, with its true characteristics and important being understood by few. MDO is not just actions on land, in sea, air, cyber space, in the electromagnetic and in the electromagnetic spectrum. It comprises operations conducted across multi-domains and contested space through convergence of capabilities to overcome an adversary strength by presenting it with operational and or tactical predicaments. Okay, this means having a common operating picture across all domains, which forms the basis to decide the best tool to address a given task. Okay, now I'm explaining the paragraph. If you have given a basic task, if you only know the one part, okay, if you have the knowledge of being operate in a land or air or water, okay, theek hai, and the task is to operate on the space, you don't have enough knowledge, you can't able to operate in it at your much potential, or you can't even operate it, okay. So it is much required, okay, to you have done it is much it is must to it is much for you, for all, for us, okay, to have a particular knowledge about everything, okay, for space, for time, for space, for air, for land, for water, for, you can say, mountains, for that, for those, for cyber, for space, for electromagnetic spectrum also. So it is being important. Now this is so multi-domain operation details. Here the domain refers to the air, land, water, space, cyber, electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, so multi-domain operation is the capability of a person to being operate in the multiple domains, multiple areas, okay, of the field. Now this means having a common operating picture across all domains, okay, as I has explained, which forms the basis to decide the best tool, okay. Hence, it is not one service using capabilities in multiple domains to do task, as in happening now, but the best positioned and capable operator of any service doing it across any domain. Thus, an army coastal missile battery could be tasked to strike an enemy naval vessel detected by radar on an Air Force aircraft, or an Air Force armed unmanned aerial vehicle on an intelligence, surveillance and recognizance mission. Okay, it is related to defense, okay, defense, or you can say governance part, okay, how our government is being governing the Indian Army, okay. And it is being also in the current affairs section. What is the MDO? What is the multiple domain? Okay, in which domains it's being operated? In which domain it's do their operations? Okay, now be diverted to use its weapon against an army target detected by a naval civilian satellite. Alternatively, a cyber weapon could be used. In simple terms, MDO architecture uses any sensor and the best positioned suitors to accomplish objectives. The technical complexity and the command, control and communication, three C's are either command, control and communication. Note down that the three C's which are being under the MDO is command, control and communication. Structure required can be well imagined. MDO and its C3 structure would have inputs from all the sensors to come up with an optimum engagement solution using artificial intelligence AI. This demands three things. First, all sensors and other information input sources must be capable to being hosted on the MDO architecture. Second, all solution providers, executors must be able to receive inputs and instructions from the MDO C3 structure and carrying them out. And third, if the link to maintain structure is not available, say jammed by the enemy, the mission command characteristics of distributed control would come into play so that operation continue. Agar jaise if the communication system is being jammed by the enemy, then the mission command characteristic, ek koi mission diya gaya uska jo command kar raha hai, jo top head hai, uski jo you can say characteristic hai of distributed control would come into play. Okay, after that, now this is complicated, for one is talking of pining technologies that only nations with a developed scientific base and financial standing can afford. It would require a de novo look at doctrine, planning, acquisition, staffing and training. This raises a doubt, does this affect India or is it a first world problem? Should New Delhi be pouring money and resources into an American concept being progressed by the US aggressively for the past decades? Okay, now the answer comes easy when one considers that China, which is attempting to match US military power, is not lagging far. It is closely watching the Russia-Ukraine conflict, where Western specialists are helping Ukrainians utilize the power of algorithms to fuse reconnaissance from the space and choose the best shooters to strike Russian targets. As an article in the Washington Post puts that the Ukrainians are fusing their courageous fighting spirit with the most advanced intelligence and battle management software ever seen in combat. Okay, this is MDO, multi-domain operations in an air-bridged form in action. If left behind, India would be deterred by denial during peacetime itself as Beijing, which has the technology and finances master it. India has no choice but to embrace MDO to four pronged strategy is suggested. First is short term, traditional physical domain must be established with critical deficiencies of the services being plugged. Second, our C3 network needed to be control communication and command control and communication. Okay, need to be hardened and protected against cyber threats. Importantly, is needed to be linked and synchronized so that seamless exchange of data is ensured. Okay, the third, for long term, a pilot project must be started now so that the true challenge of creating an MDO, multi-domain operation environment, is grasped. Presently, it is just Western literature driving theoretically discussions in the seminar circuit. The pilot project would identify the technologies required and, equally importantly, an idea of the monies necessary. And finally, to get the fundamental of MDO right, it is vital to train and educate personnel starting now. Incidentally, the US Air Force has a 1-year long training course ongoing to help develop critical thinking and problem solving skills at the operational level of war amongst joint all domain specialists, as the trainee officers would be called. Now, technology has changed the face of war. History is witness to parallel perils on the battlefield if scientific advances are overlooked. Battlefields too have changed from physical brawls to cyber and precision strikes. But if recent brawls at the Pangong So, Galwan and Yangtze and the thrust required towards multi-domain operations are yardsticks to go by strategic minds to the higher levels of military and government have a plateful of imperatives to address. This may not be an era of war, as someone famously said recently, but homilies are for politicians and not for professionals. The proverbial powder must not only stay dry but be upgraded on time. So this is the editorial, okay, in which the editor is being discussing about the introducing the new technologies to improve our defense system and attack system, okay, so to compete with the other countries also. ठीक है, एज द यूएस आर्मी इज बीइंग वेरी वेरी एडवांस्ड, ओके, इंडिया इज समवेयर लैकिंग बिहाइंड, ओके, एंड चाइना इज नॉट टू फार फ्रॉम द यूएस, ओके, इट जस्ट ट्राई टू मेंटेन इट्स मिलिट्री पावर टू एज कैपेबल एज यूएस, ओके, एंड वी ऑल नो दैट यूएस आर्मी इज बीइंग प्रैक्टिसिंग द मल्टी डोमेन ऑपरेशंस, ओके, it's being observing from the satellite that where the Russians are being targeting, and they the fire on the Russians as well, and okay, and what missiles are being they using, and after the all data receiving, they just donate, or you can say give appropriate and most advanced missile which can be effective against the Russia, okay, so this is all under, this is the US mission doing the multi domain operations, okay, वो एक डोमेन में नहीं सोच रही है, मल्टीपल डोमेन सोच रही है, उसने पूरा डाटा कलेक्ट किया, रशिया के टारगेट क्या है, उधर क्या क्या, उसके बाद उसने जो यूक्रेन है उसको एक अप्रोप्रिएट मिसाइल दी उस पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन से डील करने के लिए. ठीक है, तो ये एडवांसमेंट हमें इंडिया में भी लानी पड़ेगी, हमारे क्या जो सैनिक हैं वो जैसे अभी यांगसे और तुआंग में हुआ कि वो लोग लाठी डंडे से मार रहे हैं. ठीक है, तो वो तो चलो समहाउ इट इज इट कैन बी बेनिफिशियल बट नॉट फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम. ओके, वी कांट फाइट विद द ओनली गन्स. ओके, इफ दे आर बीइंग फाइटिंग विद द ड्रोन्स, ओके, दे आर बीइंग एट द टॉप ऑफ आवर हेड एंड बीइंग फायरिंग ऑन अस, ओके, वी कांट ओनली फाइट विद द गन्स एंड वी हैव टू मेंटेन आवर एडवांसिटी. ओके, वी हैव टू बी मोर एंड मोर सिविलाइज एंड एडवांस इन टर्म्स ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड डिफेंस सिस्टम्स. ओके, सो इट इज़ वेरी गुड, बोथ द एडिटोरियल्स ऑफ टूडे आर बींग वेरी वेरी एनर्जेटिक. ओके, इफ ब्रॉल्स एट पैंगोंग सो गलवान एंड यांगसे एंड द थ्रस्ट रिक्वायर्ड टूवर्ड्स MDO आर यार्डस्टिक्स टू गो बाई स्ट्रेटेजिक माइंड्स हैव अ प्लेटफुल ऑफ इम्पेरेटिव टू एड्रेस. लेट अस मूव फॉरवर्ड. ओके, हेयर अ लेट बट राइट कॉल बाई केरला गवर्नर बिफोर फाइनली एग्रींग टू द टू reinstate former. Okay, it is not important, I think. Yeah, okay, now text and context here. A 4-year high in Iraq's oil revenues as price collapsed. 115 in billion Iraq's oil revenues in 22, a 4-year high following a collapse in price during the COVID-19 pandemic. The country is the second largest producer with Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. Okay, Iraq petrol supply karta hai, udhar se paisa kama raha hai. The beneficiaries in Odisha to get 5 kg of rice a month free of cost. The number of Odisha State Food Security Scheme SSSP beneficiaries who will receive. Okay, civilians from ethnic Fulani group killed in Burkina Faso. A sharp drop in Turkey's inflation from 84% in December. 5 cases of COVID-19 XBB 1.5 variant found in India. It's being a new variant XBB 1. Okay, on the legality of Israel's occupation.
hear a general view of Jewish settlement of Ephrath on West Bank. Okay, how is India moving towards regulating online gaming? Not very important, yeah. Okay, Burj Khalifa, known for being the world's tallest building, opened to public on January 4, 2010. Here is a quiz on some of the tallest. January 4, so aaj ke din Burj Khalifa ki age kitni ho gayi? It's been 13 years, yaar. Okay. Yes, Bharat Jodo Yatra enters Uttar Pradesh, Priyanka calls her brother. Rahul wants India surrender before China, says BJP. NIA team investigates attacks site in Rajouri, victims claimed in Dhanjiri. 10 lakh reward, okay. Militants involved. Announced for information on militants involved. Yet to disclose. A team of National Investigation Agency visited the attack site at the Rajouri in Jammu Kashmir on Tuesday, where militants killed 6 civilians in 2 in attack potentially. So, uspe NIA deal karegi, theek hai? It's been a good step taken by the NIA to deal with such sensitive cases, okay? Constitution is the basis of vibrant democracy in India, President Murmu. President Draupadi Murmu with Rajasthan Governor Kalraj Mishra and CM Ashok Gehlot at Raj Bhavan in Jaipur. Siachin Kumar post gets first woman army officer. Here you can see an army Indian woman officer. Indian army woman officer. Okay, Captain Shiva Chauhan, an officer from the Corps of Electronics and Mechanical Engineers, became the first woman officer to be operationally deployed at Kumar Post in the Siachen Glaciers, which is located at an altitude of 515,000. Captain Shiva Chauhan, of Fire and Fury Shaft, became the first woman officer to operationally. So here, remember the name Shiva Chauhan, okay? SC raises concern on small fishermen hit by pursuit in nets. Let us move forward. It is being the world. 28 civilians killed in Burkina Faso ethnic attack. Else right people. Seoul, Seoul says talks underway over new joint nuclear exercises with US. Strikes over rising cost of living affects British rail services. Tunisia, opposition says hit by political motivated probes. It's being the China warns of measures against unacceptable travel restrictions. Israel banning. Okay. India said to I 17 billion cut in food fertilizer subsidy spend. Here you can see cloud tech key for scaling India's digital journey, says Satya Nadella, being the CEO of Microsoft. Sugar output rose 3.7% in Q4 to 121 lakh tons. Sports. So this is from my side. Okay. You must have to read newspaper daily. Yeah. It's being affected all the parts of the. It affects all the parts of the, you can say, syllabus of UPSC. Okay, you can know about something in a history in editorials. Okay, today's editorial deals with the environment and the you can say polity sections of the, you can say, right of live life. Okay, and prevention to cruelty of animal act. Okay, 1960. So that is the most important thing of a new reading newspaper. Okay, you just get a touch in every subject, okay, in every domain which is being asked in the UPSC syllabus. So it is important. Okay, now this is all from my side. So we will meet on 5 January, okay, in the 5 January analysis of the Hindu. Okay, tomorrow we will meet, and today a video of M. Lakshmikant, chapter number 2, constituent formation of constituent assembly, okay, and geography chapter 4, climate.
a video will come. You can watch it, okay? Clear your concepts and give mocks, okay? So this is all from my side. Thank you for being on the Edwards. Okay, here the your logo is being, and thanks for being here. Keep motivated, yaar. ठीक है, life है, इसको chill करके पढ़ो. Just study to gain knowledge, okay? The highest will be yours, okay? So thanks for being here, and bye bye. See you tomorrow.